Good morning to all of you. In this video, I am going to start complex number. This is my 26th part. Before telling complex number, I'd like to tell about the equation. Equation means about the quadratic equation. As you know, x square minus 1 is equal to 0. How we can find the roots? Roots means value of this variable number, that is x. Then x square minus 1 means what? X square is equal to 1. Means x is equal to what? Plus minus 1. Understood? And if x square plus 1 is equal to 0, then how we can find the roots of this variable number, roots of this quadratic equation? Means x square is equal to minus 1, then x is equal to plus minus under root minus 1. Then if about the complex number, suppose I square plus 1 is equal to 0, then I square is equal to what? Minus 1. Clear? Then where I is the imaginary part. We have two parts. First one real number and second one imaginary number. Clear? R for real, I for imaginary number. What do you mean by imaginary number? In class 10th already we have done about imaginary number. Means square root of negative number, square root of any negative number. Example, suppose minus x square, this is a square root of negative number, then we can write here minus x into x, then x under root minus means 1 here. Then in the place of under root minus 1, we can write what? X into I, that is X into I. Clear? Now there is I, it means this portion is the imaginary portion. If suppose here under root minus 3 into minus 3, this also is square root of negative number, but after simplification, after simplifying, if inside the root any negative number is there, then we can say given quotient is complex number, complex form. Then here minus into minus plus sign here, then plus 9, 9 is only 3. Now this is real number, but if minus 3 into 3, then here what? Minus 9, minus 9 is 3 into under root minus 1. What is the value of under root minus 1? Then here I is equal to under root minus 1. I is equal to under root minus 1 means I here, then we can write 3 into I. Clear? Then 3 I is the imaginary number and only 3 is the real number. Understood? If Z is equal to A plus IB. Clear? Z is equal to A plus IB, where Z is the complex number. In this complex number, A is the real part. Means A is equal to real part. Clear? And B is equal to imaginary part. Clear? It means if any numbers multiply by I, then this part will be imaginary part. If in which number, which term there is no I, this is real part in simple form. Clear? Then example, suppose 3 plus 2i. Clear? Z is equal to 3 plus 2i. This is complex number. Why? Because 3 plus 2i, in this question I is there. How we can find the real part and imaginary part? 3 means comparing comparing z is equal to a plus ib here, means a is equal to 3 and b is equal to 2. Then 3 is the real part and 2 is the imaginary part. Understood? Now I'm going to give second example here. It is first example, second example. Suppose 5i into minus 8i. If any portion is there, either in multiply or divide, subtraction or addition form, first of all, we should try to write in this form. This form means a z is equal to a plus minus ib. So, because it is not compulsory, the sign of imaginary part is positive sign. It should be negative also. Then 5i into minus 8i, now plus into minus minus sign, 5 into 8, 40, I into I square. Then I square is equal to minus 1, minus 40 into minus 1 is equal to 40. Now this 40 we can write 40 plus 0 I. Now comparing 40 plus 0 I is equal to A plus IB. A is equal to 40. Therefore, A is equal to 40 and B is equal to 0. Then, in this question, after simplification, 40 is the real part and 0 is the imaginary part. Understood? Very simple. First of all, open the bracket, multiply or divide, whatever calculations should be possible in given question. First of all, we calculate. After that, comparing result of A plus IB, then A is the real part, that is 40 here, and B is the imaginary part, that is 0. Means A is equal to 40, B is equal to 0. Okay. Now, see next question here. Question number 3 here. Under root minus 144. Clear? And minus 144. First of all, we can write minus 1 into 144. Now, what is a square root of 144? 12, under root minus 1. Then, what is the value of under root minus 1? That is I, 12 into I. In this 12 into I, we have to change into A plus IB form. A plus IB means 0 plus 12 I. Now comparing A plus IB is equal to A is equal to 0 and B is equal to 12. Once more going to tell, under root minus 144, minus 1 into 144, 144 means this is a square root of 144, minus 1 means this value is I, 12i. Now this 12i we have to write in A plus IB form, when 0 plus 12i, A is equal to 0 and B is equal to 12. Then here 0 is the real part and 12 is the imaginary part of the complex number. Understood? Okay, good. Integer power of any complex number. Complex means here I power 38, I is the complex number. Clear? How we can solve? How we can evaluate? Clear? As you know, I is equal to under root minus 1, that is I square is equal to minus 1. If any integers as the power form of I, the first of all we can break into I square, means I square power, now we will divide here. Clear? 2 ones are 2, 2 nines are 38. Means given questions, we can write I square power 19. Now, what is the value of I square? Minus 1 power 19. And we know that minus power, odd number is equal to or minus sign. And minus power, even is equal to or plus sign. Then, minus odd number is equal to minus 1. Now, we have to write real part and imaginary part. Minus 1 means we can write minus 1 plus 0 into I. That is a plus ib form and a is equal to minus 1 and b is equal to 0. Now this is real part and this is imaginary part. Clear? After simplifying, minus 1, we can write minus 1 plus 0i, and where a is equal to minus 1, b is equal to 0, a is the real part, that is minus 1, and b is equal to 0 is the imaginary part of given question. Understood? Very good. And suppose here, if a negative number is there, minus I power 73, first of all, we have to change to positive sign. I power 73 and 1 power I square. Clear? Now if odd number is there, power is odd number, when we will divide by 2 of this power, then 1 remainder is come. Then here, divide 2 3 is 6 and 2 6 is 12 into here I. You can check here. 2 6 are 12, 2 3 are 6 and 7, power is 1 plus 1, that is 73. Now here, 1 upon I square means what? Minus 1 power 36 into I. Now, minus power even number is positive sign, it means 1 by I. And, for comparing of given question to a plus ib, I should be numerator, not in denominator. Therefore, multiply by I both in numerator and denominator. Then, 1 into I into I square. I square is equal to what? Minus 1. And I by minus 1, that is minus I. Now, comparing minus I means we can write 0 plus minus R, we can write here minus I. Then comparing A plus IB form, A is equal to 0 and B is equal to minus 1. In this question, A is equal to 0, it is a real part, B is equal to minus and is imaginary part. Understood? Okay, now see the next question here. And 1 upon I, 1 by I square, clear? Plus 1 by I cube, plus 1 by I power 4. Now, in this question, we have to simplify and then find the real and imaginary part of this question. Then 1 by I here, 1 by I. I square means minus 1 plus I cube means I into I square means minus I plus I power 4 means what? I square into I square. 1 by I minus 1 by I cancel here. Minus 1 plus I square means what? 1 minus 1 minus 1. Then here plus cancel is equal to 0. How we can compare this 0 to a plus ib? Now 0 is equal to what? 0 plus 0i and a plus ib, a is equal to 0 and b is equal to 0. It means in this question a is equal to 0 is a real part and b is equal to is 0, this is also imaginary part. Understood? Okay. In this question, first of all, simplify. After that, find A and B if Z is equal to A plus IB. Clear? As you know, already I have told you, Z is complex number, Z is equal to A plus IB. A is the real part and B is the imaginary part. Now, first of all, simplify this question. I power 18, I square power 9. प्लस वन बाई आई आई बाई आई स्क्वायर 25 क्यूब. क्लियर? व्हाट इज वैल्यू ऑफ आई स्क्वायर? -1/9. क्लियर? प्लस आई स्क्वायर मीन्स व्हाट? माइनस आई पावर 25 एंड 40. नाउ माइनस पावर ऑड नंबर इज व्हाट? -1. एंड माइनस आई पावर ऑड नंबर इज आल्सो -i/25 एंड 40. क्लियर? नाउ -1 -i/2/12 × i/3 -1 -i² means what? -1. And here -1 i² means what? -1. Then minus i -1/12 × i³. Clear? Now -1 - -1 even number is positive sign -i/2. Now minus taking common for odd number here, minus sign, and inside we get 1 + i³ is equal to what? -a³ + b³ + 3a² b + 3ab² This is formula here. Because about this formula you have studied in class 9th, a + b³ = a³ + b³ + 3a² b + 3ab² Then -i³ means what? i² 3i and plus 3i² -1 i² means -i plus 3i minus 3 -3 + 1 - 2 -i + 3i + 2i Now multiply 2 - 2i. Clear? Then once more, this is question here. First of all, we have to simplify our given questions. Anyhow, we have to change into this form. This means z is equal to a + ib. By calculation, by step, already I have changed given question into this form 2 - 2i. Now comparing a + ib, that is a = 2 and b = -2. Then a = 2 is the real part and b = -2 is the imaginary part of given question. Understood? Then please learn i² = what? -1. And we can write i² √-1. This is very important because in this chapters, in maximum questions, we will use about i² = -1 or i² √-1. And first one, second things, z = a + ib. Z is the complex number. In complex number, there are two parts. A is the real part and B is the imaginary part. Here A is the real part. a = what? Real part. And b = what? Imaginary part. Clear? With the help of real imaginary parts, we can calculate maximum question of complex number. And in next video, I will tell about how we can find the magnitude of this complex number and argument means amplitude of this question. Clear? In next video, I will tell you. That's why once more going to tell, please you maintain all the questions and make a copy. And how many questions I am giving in your homework, please try to do question. Okay, thank you very much.